The paper airplane you folded in middle school, horrible design. But I've thrown a paper airplane 214 feet. I'm John Collins. I am the paper airplane guy, world record holder for paper aircraft distance. So the year we got the record was 2012. It was, one of the great days in my life, actually. I look back at my child being born and the world record. Those are great moments for me. I named the world record plane after my wife. The name of the design is Suzanne. But this is how you fold Suzanne. You start with the short side of the paper up,
top of the page,
and put it against the right
side.
So now when you unfold that,
you've got an X in the paper.
After that is to take the right hand
straight down
from the top of the plane.
And you fold the plane in half.
It's just 8 simple folds. There are a lot of different kinds of folding techniques and a lot of different kinds of paper airplanes. There's planes that boomerang back. There are planes that are made to fly straight very far. There are planes that are made to stay in the air for a long time. Every great paper airplane, distance or time aloft, has very accurate folding. Most people want to know how I got into paper airplanes, and the reality is I never got out of them. I am curious by nature. I love math and science. The cool thing about paper airplanes is it's a way to actually discover something real about flight. What most people don't know is that we don't know the exact cause and effect for lift. Every little paper airplane throw is like a little science experiment. Here's the laboratory right here in your hand that you could use to do real science. Teachers kind of don't like kids to do paper airplanes. It has this bad boy kind of renegade reputation. If they could discover that paper airplanes actually are science, that they're doing science and having fun doing it, I think that's an incredible breakthrough. Paper airplane throwing class, yes.